Christ system. And if you look at Islam, what do they want to do? Change the laws of the world.
Sure.
So all this interpretation that we had in the West about, you know, what is this about changing the laws? They think it's the cosmos or this. No, it's simply what it says.
You pointed out that Allah in the Quran, am I correct in this, is actually a deceiver, that he has the attributes of Satan himself?
Well, the 99 names of Allah are very well known in Islam.
Yeah.
Some of these names, if you look at them, one of the names of Allah in the Quran is Al-Mutakabbir, which means the most proud one. Mm. When I read the Bible as a Muslim, and I saw the most proud one in the Bible was Satan, or Al-Mumit, the one who causes death.
Well, exactly. Well, you know, I'm just writing a book. I've just finished one on humility. And the truth is the root sin of the world is pride.
Right.
Yeah, I will exalt myself upon the throne of God.
And that's the problem, where Muslims cannot see the truth from the Bible.
But the one that they say is Allah is the most proud
one? The most. We say Al-Mutakabbir.
Yeah.
It's the El, like the Elohim.
Yeah, yeah.
El is the most proud one. So the most proud one is Allah.
But that's really Satan.
Exactly. And it's worse than that, because he's the one who causes death, Al-Mumit.
Yeah.
Al-Makir, the great deceiver.
Yes.
This is the names of Allah in the Quran. So
they really believe the great deceiver.
Yes.
I mean, in America, we don't hear this.
Yes. In the Quran, it says, وَيَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. They, you know, Allah is the greatest of all deceivers. So it is okay. That's why Islam has deception and war. Mm. That's why Islam offers hudna, or a peace treaty, to non-Muslims up to 10 years, but they must break the peace treaty somewhere.
Well, the hudna was Oslo. In other words,
you Americans called it the Oslo Peace Accord.
Yeah.
We called it the Oslo Hudna Accord.
Hudna.
So a hudna is a treaty. It's actually not a peace treaty. It's a ceasefire. In Islam, we're allowed to have a ceasefire for two reasons. First, reason number one, to gain concessions.
Yes.
Reason number two, to deceive the enemy and destroy them in the end.
What about the Bush administration, Condoleezza Rice? Bush comes out and says this is a religion of peace. Condoleezza Rice has a celebration at the end of Ramadan and honors these people on account of this great religion. Are they deceived?
It's a deception. I mean, CARE, Council of American Islamic Relations, they say we condemn terrorism. We condemn terrorism. Mm. Well, what we need to do as Americans is to say, wait a minute, condemning a terrorism is not a verb, it's an act. How are you condemning terrorism by act? If you look at all the Islamic organizations, the American Muslim Council, you know, all of them, by far, if you look at the demonstrations, what do they say? Khaybar, Khaybar, ya Yahud, Jaish Muhammad, Sawfa Ya'ud. I know the Arabic. Khaybar is where the Jews were destroyed in Saudi Arabia by the Prophet Muhammad. Mm-hmm. And they're chanting in the demonstrations saying, don't forget, Jews, what Muhammad, the Prophet of Islam, did to you in Saudi Arabia, in Khaybar, in Medina.
If you were going to stop Islam, what would you do?
We have to understand, this Islamic movement is a cancer.
Yes.
It is a cancer not only that will destroy itself, but it will also destroy us in the process. We must isolate the cancer and have it destroy itself. We have to get out of oil, because that's the only reason why we're so much involved in the Middle East, because
oil.
Of the oil interest.
Oil. All right.
If we get out of oil, because mm-hmm. oil is the wine that is causing the intoxication of the nations, and we're selling out on Israel, we're selling out on Christians for the reason of this oil. So if we can get off oil, get into alternate source of energy, I think both Republicans and Democrats should be happy. Both liberals and conservatives should be happy. Then we can isolate the Middle East and get rid of the problem. So I think isolating it and then crushing a major terror organization, because what we're doing in the West is we're building the confidence of Islamists. We're forcing Israel to pull out of Gaza.
Yeah.
So we're supporting regimes that is not pro-America at all. And so building the confidence is what we have done in the past. Even in Afghanistan, we aided the Mujahideen against the communists. That was, in a way, a mistake.
The CIA funded the
Mujahideen.
That's right. Mujahideen.
That's right.
Yeah.
And when they defeated Russia, mm-hmm. guess what? Now they can defeat America. And Israel wanted to destroy Hamas, Hezbollah and Hamas. What did we say? Israel must pull out of Lebanon. So we twisted Israel's arm to pull out of Lebanon. That built more confidence and more confidence.
And,
it's just
and,
like the stock market.
And democratic elections, too. We want to have, I remember the Bush saying, oh, we've had a democratic election in the West Bank, and Hamas won.
In fact, 113,000 Arabs in the Middle East were asked the question, do you prefer Hamas or the PLO? Pat, 73.2% chose Hamas over the PLO. What this is saying, I mean, this is a survey done by Al-Arabiya Network, an mm-hmm. Arab institution.
Yeah.
113,000 Muslims chose radical Islam. And that's not just in the Palestinian areas. In Pakistan, 56% want radical Islam. In Jordan, if you have elections, they will choose radical Islam. In Egypt, if you have elections, they will choose radical Islam. In Iraq, if you have elections. We're seeing this over and over again, the rise of Islam. We see a civil war happening now in the Palestinian areas, in which Hamas will be victorious. I've been saying this since 1993.
Yeah.
I said Lebanon will turn Muslim fundamentalist. Palestine that we're creating, a state is not a state, it's a state of psychosis that will end up in an Islamic fundamentalist. I said Turkey will end up electing Muslim fundamentalist organization. We have
You're
the AKP,
right.
the Refah Party. Turkey was the eastern part of the Roman Empire. We as Christians are waiting for a revival of a Roman Empire. Do we forget what is going to happen from the eastern part of the Roman Empire?
One last question. I see our time's running up, but do you think they're going to try to blow up something big here in America? Are they bloodthirsty to try to really kill a whole many of Americans?
Pat, they've already tried. They haven't succeeded. 10 airplanes to blow up, Sears Tower, and lately trains they want to blow up, and all these things, they haven't succeeded. They want to do a grand finale. If you look at every single terror operation that they attempted to do, and they've succeeded in 9/11, is a grand finale to destroy this country. This is why I thank God for your program, that we're telling Americans really what's going on. A grand finale that will cripple the economy of the United States of America, because America is the mama bear. America is the police force that is stopping tyrants in the Middle East. They must destroy and cripple this economy and this country.
And I understand there's been a fatwa issued that gives them permission to kill 10 million Americans. Is that right?
This fatwa is galore. You know, the fatwa has been going on for years.
Yeah.
Islam is simply a religion that was wounded and wants to heal its wound. The Westerners don't understand. The reason they hate us so much, they hate the West so much, is because we have dismantled the caliphate. Yeah. The caliphate that was in Turkey, in the Ottoman Empire. They want to revive the caliphate. This is the whole call for reviving the caliphate. It is a wounded beast that wants to heal its wound and rise again to dominate, as in the glory days when Islam dominated the East. That's what it wants to do. It has nothing to do with Israel. It has nothing to do with poverty. It uses poverty just to say America is at fault.
Sure.
Zionist conspiracies and all these things.
Well, you're fascinating. I know we've got to move on. You've got other guests, but it's Why We Want to Kill You. You ought to read it, folks. Everybody in this audience ought to read this, and I wish the people who made policy in Washington, D.C. would read it. It's available in bookstores everywhere. Why We Want to Kill You. And, Waleed, it's a pleasure to have you back
with
us.
I'd love to see you again.